Good evening. Welcome to this regular meeting of the Northside Board of Trustees. Before I call the meeting to order, I'd like to take just a moment to briefly review some of the rules for conducting our meeting. The order of business for this meeting is set out on the agenda. One item that you may notice on the agenda is called the consent agenda. It includes items that are considered routine or are of a recurring nature. All the items listed under the consent agenda will be acted upon in one motion. If there is a consent agenda item which anyone here would like to address, please sign up to speak to that item and we will pull it from the consent motion and discuss it separately. The purpose of our meeting is to conduct board business and for that reason it is held in public. It is not a public forum. However, we do provide the opportunity for audience participation. If there is anyone here who would like to address the board during an agenda item or citizens to be heard portion of the agenda, we ask that you please complete a sign-up sheet located at the entrance to this room. This is so we do not overlook anyone who would like to speak to the board. We will review the rules for addressing the board later in the meeting. Is there anyone here who would like to sign up to an agenda item and has not done so? I don't see a mad rush, so I assume we're all okay. So the meeting will then be officially called to order. Please stand as Trustee Medina leads us in the invocation and the pledges of allegiance.
Almighty and merciful God, we ask you for your guidance on the blessings upon the board, students, parents, patrons, teachers, and administrators. As we assemble here this evening in the common pursuit of this great nation's wealth, our children. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Thank you, Mr. Medina. I want to welcome all of you here tonight, and I have a number of people who are students at Northwest Vista, I believe. Can you all stand and wave or whatever?
Yay. Welcome.
Yeah, and back there, too. So.
Wow.
Good. Welcome. And you are in Dr. Marbit's government class?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay. Great. Nice to have you here. It's going to be a short meeting, so you got really lucky tonight. Okay. We're moving down to, first the superintendent's report.
Yes, ma'am, Ms. Reed and members of the board. A few things to report to you this evening. I'm going to start by thanking the board for your participation in our Educators of the Year celebrations. A couple of weeks ago now, we had those, and that is a great opportunity for us to really recognize some outstanding people in our district, and we certainly appreciate your being there with us. I want to report to the board, I think you know this, that we had a young man, Seth Wattes, who is a fifth grader at Lewis Elementary, won the citywide contest for the Cavaliers River Parade art, and that's pictures of Seth up there now. He is quite a talented artist. This is actually the second time a student from Lewis has won the contest outright. And then you see we had a number of other Northside students who were recognized as finalists in the city council district. So congratulations to all those talented young folks and their teachers, and certainly especially to Seth. He gets to ride on the Grand Marshal's float and do the parade
wow.
wave and the whole nine yards. So
wow.
He also got Whataburger for a year.
Oh.
The crowd was in general agreement, just like this crowd, that was the way to go. That was the special part, no doubt about it. I also want to thank several members of this board for your participation in the mayoral town hall last night. Northside was extremely well represented at that event. We got to listen to two of the candidates talk about their views. Again, I just want to thank you for your time in that. Also, and I know some of you are aware of this, recently the cabinet member and I challenged each other to go and spend an entire day with an elementary student and really follow their experience that up there. And while all of us, I think, had a really positive experience, we also had some really eye-opening is that we will come back and put together. Monica, do you have the one of Stan Lang sitting with the kindergartners on the floor? That one's just really, really special. For those of you who don't know Stan Lang, he's about 6'5", so picture him in a kindergarten room. Yeah, so, yeah, great experience. And we thanks. I think some of the cabinet members came away from PE and recess and had to have a little that evening at home. But otherwise, all were unscathed.
There's somebody on the floor.
Yeah, that's Mr. Jarrett. Yeah, absolutely. The spent a little time in Austin, well, quite a lot of time in Austin lately, including some time today. And you all are familiar with the phrase, watching the sausage. And it is not, indeed, not pretty at all. And so we are in the thick of the session. We are tracking bills related to board governance, to reform of the A through F system that I know a lot of people in this room have passion around. Certainly school finance, the Senate passed out their version of their budget today. It does not do anything positive for public schools. We're tracking legislation on vouchers, transparency and ballot language, which is certainly something that's important to fast growth districts like us. So a lot going on in the legislative session. And while I think we all read articles that are not in a positive light about public schools and how the legislature treats public schools, there are clearly people who believe in the value of public education in the legislature who are working very hard, sometimes against a significant tide. And certainly if you have any time there, you can see that. So much more to come, much more reading and analysis to be done on that. I did want to just mention on just my behalf, lately a lot of us were saddened by the news that former Northside superintendent, long-serving superintendent, and long-serving Northside employee in many, many roles, Jack Jordan, passed away. The service was actually this afternoon, beautiful ceremony, I thought honored him, his service to students, to kids, and to how he was as a person, as a man, today. And I just wanted to add my condolences to Ann and the family of Jack Jordan, and wish them well as they try to get past this and move on with the rest of their lives. So just wanted to make that comment. So with that, I'll awkwardly transition. There was no other better way to do that, to a video moment. So ready, Monica? So we've got a video moment related to our HEB Excellence in Education Award nominee.
You did $15.09 gives you $24. I've been a teacher for 13 years. I decided to come into teaching. My experiences in my life as a young child, and I want to ignite the fire in my students. Which one are we going to select? Walk me step by step.
Ms. Carrasco, and she's a special teacher.
Got that? Mm-hmm. Any questions?
She wants us to know what's going on. She doesn't just go on. She doesn't just make us copy
the evidence. What in the book tells you that he's brave?
She connects with us. She is like one of us.
You're right. He's brave. Or to say, why is he brave? Okay? Those are questions you need to be thinking about as you're reading. It's a hard job. Just have spring break coming up. It's a tough job. Why is it relevant? Daniel? But at the end of the day, you do it for the kids. You do it for the right reasons. You're making that like you do on a daily basis. You just never know. Never know. But thank you. So I was told they were coming in to do a collaborative setting. center. The cameras came in and they directly to me. I was just like, oh my God, Dr. Woods was like,
good morning.
Good morning.
We've got a little special announcement to make. Ms. Carrasco, can you stand up for just a second? So in San Antonio, HEB recognizes excellence in the classroom, and Ms. Carrasco is being recognized for her excellence in teaching. Congratulations.
This is a dream come true because you just never know, like, how much emphasis and how much of an emphasis, and that's what I'm here for, and just to make a difference in those kids and those little Georgette's life, because I experienced some things that children maybe are facing today, and I just want to let them know that they can be successful in life.
So the way that the HEB Awards works, and they call it, and I agree, it's kind of the Oscars of teaching, right? It really recognizes some outstanding folks. Ms. Carrasco is among five finalists statewide, and then those finalists will be interviewed by a panel in early May, and then honored at an awards banquet in around that same time. So congratulations to her. She is a special, special individual, no doubt about it. With that, Ms. Reed, that concludes Superintendent's Report.
Well, the people that are going to be interviewing her, it's too bad if they cannot see her in the classroom with her children, because that's really special to see how she's pulling out of them the ability for them to sit and think about how they can move forward. So that was quite remarkable, I thought.
They do get to see a video, though.
The communications group will make a video of her that kind of highlights some interviews with her, but also some seeing her
classroom.
Teach some,
yeah.
Which I agree is will speak well of her, no
That's
doubt about
great.
It.
That's great. Well, congratulations to her. This is a time for board members to share. If we have any board members that would like to mention some things, I guess I should mention that we do have our vice president is not going to be with us tonight. She is at a dinner with her daughter-in-law, whose birthday it is tonight. So that's one of those special things that you have to do with your family occasionally. So anyway, comments? Dr. Harrell.
Thank you, President Reed. I was just, since we have so many students, and I hope future educators, but for sure future mentors, to students. Anyone can be a mentor. So I just want to talk about, there was a program that John Glenn recently participated in called Writing for Readers, or it could be Biking for Books. Either way, there was an organization that they ride and they collect books and really nice books for kids and distribute them. But when the books get there, they ride off. And so I got to see that, and the kids were delighted, and they were tickled to have books in their hands. But it'd be really neat. So I was just adding icing on the cake. If folks in this room could get the word out that they also like to be read to, and they like to have a mentor, someone to look up to. So I said I would kind of do an all call. I also found out that there is a Scholastic Warehouse where you can go buy books for like $1.99, $1.49, and our librarians know about it, but anyone can go to it, anyone. So I went out over spring break and got a bunch of books and went back over there, and some of the comments the kids said when they got the book that I wanted to share with you again to kind of say, please go sign up to mentor at any of our schools, where, oh my gosh, I got a hardback book, or it's a new book, or I got to pick the book I wanted. And you know, it's hard to leave that those comments without, you know, teared up eyes and going, oh my gosh, all this excitement about books. But I think the bikers felt it that day. I mean, the bicyclists, They said, don't call us bikers. The bicyclists felt it that day, and so I went back again. These kids are just so phenomenal. So I put that charge out to you. The other thing that I want to do another wonderful thank you shout out to is we have an incredible instructional technology department. And Dana Bickley and Elizabeth Robles taught me how to Twitter. And it's actually not so much about Twittering, the act itself, but seeing all, or tweeting, I'm sorry, someone I know. bikers, I'll get it, but you get the gist. But thank you. The more I hear corrections, the more I can grow. So, but we can see all kinds of incredible things that are going on at our schools. You know, we'll soon have 117. It's hard to see what's going on in classrooms. But teachers, like you saw in the video tonight, show pictures and videos of their kids learning and working together and what the products look like and what they learned at a staff development. And so I got really tickled. And so it's the way I start my mornings now. It's kind of a way to be very grateful for representing and being part of Northside is to tweet back. Okay, good, yeah. Good. And it's now just a really nice relationship piece. The other thing is, Dana Bickley asked if I was reading any kind of a good book, and I just finished one called Steal Like an Artist. And so we were able to do an ed chat, and Dr. Woods did an ed chat too. And I'm telling you what, if you could burn calories doing it, I think I would have, you know, run a marathon. But it was great. Questions were posed, responses were given, incredible insights by our teachers, and the Ed Chat was archived. And so Steal Like an Artist really is about applications of creativity in your life and in your classroom. And so it just was phenomenal. And there's Ed Chats all the time. So I wanted to thank them and the whole department and then all the teachers and educators who spend time getting the word out of what's going on at our schools. And then again, I guess it's a debt of gratitude we owe to Mr. Jack Jordan. It was a great service today, but one of the things they talked about a story where he had polio when he was little, and his grandmother would take care of, massage his legs, work on his legs every day, so much so that in the beginning stages he couldn't make it up the stairs. He literally had to pull himself, but then ran up the stairs over time. And then became an athlete in high school and college. But we talked to our kids and our teachers so much about grit, having grit. And that was the best true grit story I've heard in a long time. That showed a lot of grit and determination. That's what we want in all our kids and all our teachers. So anyway, he exemplified that up until the end. So Jack Jordan up by the Texas flag, we will miss you. Thank you, Ms. President.
Thank you, Carol. Anybody? Somebody.
Thank you, Ms. Reed. I was actually hoping for Bobby to push the button because I was going to ask him, or I wanted him to talk about it before I made a comment about it, but I know that that's what he's going to talk about later on. Also, thank you, Bobby, for organizing the Bexar County School Boards Coalition meeting. We have a coalition of school boards in Bexar County, and most recently, or this past year, we are hosting our meetings at other districts or district school board to coincide with their school board meetings, and so we're actually invited to their board meeting. And this past last week we were invited to South San, and so it's a learning experience for all of us, and to be able to see other school boards and their facilities and what they do, and to share best practices. So thank you, Bobby. Bobby is our Bexar County School Board Coalition President. Also at your place, I have passed out Helotes Chamber medals. As you know, I'm sit on the board for the Helotes Chamber. It is a gift from me, so you're welcome. I hope you enjoy that. The Helotes Chamber for the second year has produced medals. The proceeds will benefit a scholarship for students that graduate this year, and they have to live in the, because of the Helotes Chamber location, the Brandeis or O'Connor attendance zone. They don't necessarily have to go to Brandeis or O'Connor, but they need that, so that would include private schools or whomever. Brandeis and O'Connor, and the last, the deadline to apply for that particular scholarship is April the 21st. The medal actually features Floors Country Store celebrating its 75th year in business. So anyway, also to my fellow board members, the Texas Association of School Boards, we're having a directors meeting this week, and I've been invited to sit on in an ESSA meeting hosted by TEA. TEA's Mark Baxter. Even though the plans, the federal regulation plans at the federal level have been kind of halted, TEA is still moving forward with presenting their plan for ESSA for the Texas plan to the Department of Ed. So we're going to be talking about that. That should be an interesting meeting. The Texas Association of School Boards at a meeting too. I know we'll be talking about several bills, as Dr. Woods has mentioned. Just for your interest, there have been 6,851 bills filed this legislative session. Of those, 2,476 bills deal with education, and TASB's following those bills. And that would be all, Ms. Reed.
Thank you. Mr. Blunt.
Yeah, to follow up with Karen, one of the things I liked about the coalition meeting, it's just it's really building up how close and the trustees across the San Antonio area are and becoming. So it's really good to see the collaborative group. We're going to be going to San Antonio. I understand some of y'all went to San Antonio last night, earlier this week. We're going to be going there, I think, next month or in the May time period to observe their board meeting. They have one interesting thing, though, and we may have it other places, but I have not seen it. They had a planetarium it was fascinating to see. I'd never seen that anywhere else before, but that was very, very interesting to see on the third floor of their building. Karen also mentioned we had our Heroes for Health event. I do want to really thank Dr. Woods, Deputy PE staff, and all the campuses. We had the biggest participation we've ever had from the fire department, the police department, and the sheriff department. And basically, they go out on, I think it's March 6th, correct? Dr. Woods, remember right? On one day, they were all at the different elementary schools we have promoting health and fitness. And you know, they were the heroes and saying, this is important to me, so it was great to see. But in addition, Northside, I mean, even with all those folks there, you still can't get enough because the number of elementary schools we have in this county, let alone Northside. So thanks to our police, because they fill in the gaps with quite a few of our own officers on Northside that also serve as those heroes. But the campus is really putting on a lot of work, more than what we all realize in terms of, you know, you've got a new person coming in, you don't necessarily know who's this hero, coordinate that part of it. Pulling all the kids out, imagine pulling a whole campus out of 700 to 1,000 kids and orchestrating that across the board with a different type of messaging. So it was really great. And some got very creative again this year. So thanks again, Northside, and all the districts in San Antonio. And that's all I had, Katie.
Okay, thank you, Bobby. I was going to add something on there, and I can't remember what it was now. the school is. It was just actually opened last fall, so it's a brand new high school that they have, and it does have some unique things. And we also visited their culinary arts area, so they're sort of moving into the 21st century along with the rest of us, which I think is a good thing for them. Okay, Mr. Lopez.
Thank you, Katie. Yeah. Sorry. Thank you, Katie. Yeah, I too, along with Trustee Medina, he and I went to the mariachi festival, or the competition. We were really impressed with it. We got to see Holmes High School perform, and I believe they came out with a number 2 rating. So my congratulations to Holmes High School and their achievement with their award on that or on their judging. This is a real big It was a real big time for them because they were a small group. And had you seen the competition, I mean, they were competing against mariachi groups that had 20 people and 20 musicians. And even though they had 14, they sounded like 22. So, I mean, it was very, I was very impressed to see the kids not be intimidated by that. They played their hearts out. They really were proud of what they were playing, and it showed in their music. So, you know, I know I was impressed, and both, you know, Trustee Medina and I were looking at each other like, man, these are some good kids. I mean, they're really good musicians. And some of the music that they were playing wasn't easy. I mean, these were traditional songs that you have to play a certain way, and in mariachi music. So it was very good to see them and hear them play. My hat goes off to Aaron Rios, the instructor, who really had worked with them in their presentation. So I'm very proud to see them achieve what they've achieved. Second, I'll just add on to what Dr. Wood said and everybody else has said about, you know, former Superintendent Jack Jordan. You know, he will be missed. I think a lot of what he has done, his vision, they talked about it there in the at the ceremony. I was there. They talked about his vision and what he had for Northside when it was just a smaller district. And, you know, his dreams, his hopes will move on, will live on through his family. I know they'll live on through Northside family as well. And they'll also live on through the North Jack Jordan Middle School. So, you know, my heart goes out to the family, and I wish them well. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lopez. Mr. Medina.
Thank you, Ms. Reed. I also wanted to continue recognizing Brennan High School for hosting the Teachers of the Year presentations. They were, you know, as a teacher, you know, watching others receive their awards, it was, you know, not only meaningful for the families because of the dedication that they have for their students, but also their administrators going out there to support them. It's extremely rewarding to see all those teachers stand up there with pride, supporting their campuses as well. I also wanted to recognize all the efforts that both our secondary and elementary have put forth to in preparation for the state assessments. Witness some of our high schools athletes visiting elementaries and you know, celebrating, actually motivating and inspiring our younger elementaries students to work very and set goals for them to achieve their success. But again, I wanted to also recognize all the teachers that are preparing, and though they are they're very difficult, the students, a difficult task, the students are, you know, capable, and I think all the preparation in the end, they'll come on top. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Obviously, we've all been busy doing things. I wanted to mention one other thing that was kind of way back in the early part of March. The Texas Association of School Boards has a session for board members called the Winter Governance and Legal Seminar, and it's normally held in Corpus Christi. It has been for a number of years. And actually noticed in the their information that they have a panel of students that are selected that have applied for a scholarship, and they pick four of them from around the state to be on a panel discussion at a luncheon while we're there. And I noticed that one of them was a student. So I said to Mrs. Freeman, I said, are you going? She wasn't going. I said, well, I guess I will go. And so then she decided to go too. So the two of us were there to hear an outstanding student from Brandeis High School who has only been in this country for 3 years. She's one of the refugee students, and she speaks four languages and is just a fantastic student at Brandeis. She has not an easy background of information, and her name is Naomi Al-Yafai or something like that. Her aunt was with her, and her teacher, who helps the refugee students there at Brandeis. She probably weighs about 90 pounds. She's a real little person, but her aunt was even smaller. But she was just so knowledgeable and did such a great job, and I'm so glad that we were able to go to hear her, and hopefully maybe we can have her maybe come by one of the board meetings just to get some recognition. One of the other things that I did just recently, you all on the board probably know that my husband is the president of the Santa Maria Medical Foundation, which deals with the land and the medical center. And so our Health Careers High School is on, and all the facilities that we have there are sitting on land that were owned by the foundation, and they gave us that land. So since Jim's been the president, he's tried to make sure that Health Careers is always involved in what they're doing, because those students are actually doing internships at the medical school and have a great relationship with the medical community. So they just had their annual meeting, and they invited 8 students to come with the principal to be at that luncheon. And they have kind of a reception for the dignitaries to begin with. And I must tell you that when those students came into that reception and started visiting with the doctors and the people that were involved there, they impressed them, and they impressed me tremendously. The principal was saying I was glowing, and I was, because I was so proud of them. The youngest, one of the smallest ones again, is a girl who last year as a junior scored 100 on her SAT. And she has a scholarship to go to Harvard next year. Then there were these great big tall boys that kind of dwarfed her, and 2 of them were twins from the Bernie area, because that's the magnet program that's for this area, not just for Northside. So they were just, I see we have a teacher here from Health Careers. They were a fantastic group of students, and the board there was so impressed that they definitely want to have, the foundation wants to have a tour of the campus. And so we're going to make sure that that happens also. So, at the funeral today, I guess I'm the only one left here who actually served with Mr. Jordan as the superintendent, and it was a very, very nice service. And the interesting part, after the service, I think I could not take 2 steps without running into people who were namesakes for our schools, our past superintendents and so forth, and also from Harlandale, because that's where he ended his career. So it was, it's been a real special day today because of that. And we will keep his family in our prayers as they move forward. So with that having been said, if nobody else has anything else to mention, we will move forward to the next item that's on our agenda, which is the consent agenda. Have you all had a chance to look at the consent agenda? Any questions on the consent agenda?
Second.
Thank you. It's been moved and seconded that we approve the consent agenda as presented. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, no. Motion carries. Thank you very much. Get to the end of that. So we're ready to hear Citizens to be Heard, and we do have 2 people that did sign up for Citizens to be Heard. We know that this is important and meaningful, and we will listen to what you have to say. We value your opinions, although we are restrained by law from taking any action on your comments. Please come and use the podium, address your remarks to the board, and confine your remarks to a Northside policy or practice, limiting your remarks to 3 minutes. At 2 minutes, the board secretary will hold up the yellow card. At 3 minutes, the board secretary will hold up the red card, and then we ask you to wrap up. You don't have to stop in mid-sentence, but to wrap up your remarks at that point. And we ask that you not make personal attacks on any individuals, and we ask that there should be no applause or negative response by the audience. So, that having been said, we'll call the first person, Mr. Carrillo? I can't pronounce your first name. So.
That's right. Chris is fine. Well, good evening.
Well, no, pronounce it for the record, okay?
For the record, it's Arnulfo.
Arnulfo, okay.
Arnulfo Carrillo.
Thank you.
Thank y'all for at least inviting me to come in and speak to you on this subject. But I think now that we have, haven't been paying attention, or if we can, look into a new alternative high school. The one we have right now is too small. And we have a lot of students, and we keep building new high schools and new more people are moving into our district. I think we need another campus or a bigger campus, because those kids, some of them just don't complete the time there, and they're missing out.
So okay.
If we could, I would hope that we would build a new campus for them.
Okay. Thank you. Dr. Woods, why don't you mention for the students that are here what students are at our alternative campus high school?
We've got multiple alternative campuses. I think the campus that we're talking about here is the one on Hunt Lane across from Pease Middle School. So that's the alternative high school. We place students there for various lengths of time, depending upon the reason that that they go. And the setting is really meant to deal with the issue and then try to get the student back to campus in as short a period of time as we can. There is some statutory issues with some particular students there. I don't know the number of students off the top of my head, but it's something we could easily.
Well, and it's one of those numbers that grows throughout the school year.
Typically, maxes out in the spring. Obvious reasons to anybody who's worked in school, right?
Just for the information of those who are not familiar with who is at our alternative school. Okay, Ron?
I apologize. Don't want to get too close. My hearing aids will go off. Dear board members, superintendents, and administrators, thank you for giving us this opportunity to speak to you. I do want to say off my notes, Ms. Reed, I do agree. My daughter graduated from Health Careers as well. Wonderful school, and she did her internship in the medical center. We are here to bring to you and respond to an inquiry of regarding the issue ourselves coming back to with alarming regularity. Duty-free lunch is being taken away from teachers during STAR test, which is a violation of state-mandated law. We have brought this issue up on previous occasions and in the last board meeting, and in hopes that it would be addressed by the administration, as we were giving ample notice. Ms. Chumley asked us what the extent of the problem was. We went ahead and conducted a survey of our members. The results in front of you are provided to you. We have given to you. It indicates the widespread nature of this problem. We had respondents from over 57 campuses in just a few days. Almost 48% of the respondents said their campus is taking away their duty-free lunch. This is very disheartening. We call ourselves the destination district, and we take a lot of pride. It seems the attitude on many campuses and with the administrators is that it's okay to sacrifice, shortchange our teachers' legal. We urge you to dispel this notion by taking swift and defining action to resolve and address this issue within Northside Schools. In addition, we also urge you to look into the problem of taking away planning time from teachers in the name of meetings. This is a year-round violation, and one which we have repeatedly tried to proactively reach out to you and administration without much success. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay. I think I just messed up my thing here, so I'll look this up. The next item on our agenda then is under construction, and it's about our summer school programs, and Dr. Jordan's going to present that.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Reed, Dr. Woods, and trustees. Provided for your approval are the summer school programs that we're planning to offer for this summer, 2017. Included in these offerings are what we consider the regular summer school program, elementary, middle, and high, that focus on students who are either going to be retained or who have failed some courses. In addition, we have what we call support summer school. That typically is for students who did not meet the standard on STAR and need to have some required acceleration or some sort of bridge between their levels. And finally, we have enrichment programs, which provide some opportunities for children, not only in the content areas, but also in the fine arts. So at this time, we ask the board if they would approve the 2017 summer school plan as presented.
Mr. Blunt, did I miss you earlier? Or is this,
no, it's okay, Blunt. I'll go ahead and I'll vote for it.
Second. Yeah. Dr. Harl?
We met in academics committee last week and actually went through just about everything. It was phenomenal, all the way from 3 years to 103. So, I just had one real quick question. That'll be posted on our website as well, right?
Yes,
for
ma'am.
Our families to mm-hmm. see. Okay, can tweet it out? No, I'm just. Thank you
yes,
very much. I know that took a lot of effort on the part of staff, so thank you very much.
I think the document's actually 88 pages
it,
long.
It was huge. It was a book.
It would be a heck of a tweet.
It would have been.
Probably nobody
thank
would
you
like.
To your department.
Yeah. It's amazing the opportunities that are there for in the summertime. It's just really fantastic. So any other comments? If not, we have a motion and a second. Ms. Freeman, did you have a comment?
I just wanted to add, be any reason that any of our students say that I'm bored this summer with all of the stuff that we have going on in Northside. I hope a lot of our students take advantage of the programs that are being offered.
Okay. So it's been moved and seconded. All those, are we already voted? We voted?
No.
No. I'm confused. It's been moved and seconded that we approve the summer plans as presented. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Thank you. We have one more for you, Dr. Jordan. State instructional materials.
Yes, ma'am. I think this is the big one that many of the audience members are here for. As you're aware, Proclamation 2017 from TEA includes instructional materials up for adoption within the content areas of career and technical education, languages of English, special topics in social studies, algebraic reasoning, and statistics. Northside ISD uses a thorough and comprehensive process that involves every teacher within that content area to have an opportunity to weigh on his or her choice. The way it works, if you recall, you adopted or approved rather the district textbook committee. At this point, I want to recognize any district textbook committee members in the audience, if you'd stand, so we can thank you for your work.
There are a bunch.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah.
These folks really carried a heavy weight because what they did, they worked with the subject area committees because we have a committee for any content area that's under adoption. So those groups worked and they came out with some clear recommendations of what they think would be best for Northside's children. So at this time, those recommendations have been provided to you and our request is that they be approved as submitted.
Okay, thank you. I know at the academics committee we certainly looked at it. And Dr. Harl, you want to comment?
No, that's what I was going to add. We not only talked about the service that you gave because it is not, you don't get any compensation. You get, I guess, the thanks that you really studied and looked at what our kids deserve and you came up with the best recommendation. We went pages and pages and looked at them. They looked exciting. A few of those I would love to go back and learn. Very exciting choices over a very difficult process. So thank you on behalf of the district that you're here today. And again, academics, no questions, only acclamations.
Okay. You'll make comment now?
I would if the board would consider either a motion that includes two things or two separate motions. So Dr. Jordan's presentation and instructional materials themselves that cover those five areas, subject areas that she mentions. We also need the board approval for the instructional materials allotment TEEC certification, where the board is saying, yes, we understand that the materials that that we are recommending do meet the state requirements.
I move that we'll go ahead and vote for one. We approve the instructional materials as outlined in our board book.
Second. Any other comments? If not, it's been moved and seconded that we approve the instructional materials selection as presented. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed, no. Motion carries.
I get also moved we approve the TEKS aligned
certification.
Thank you.
Second. Okay. I think Bobby seconded it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so. You won it.
Congratulations.
Yeah. There are no comments. It's been moved and seconded that we approve the TEKS certification as presented. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Jordan.
Ms. Reed, before you move on, and I know there's some folks in here who probably want to go do some other things tonight. I just want to echo the thanks to these teachers that represented all of these subject areas. And Dr. Jordan said it well. They carry a heavy load. If you look at these subject areas, we probably have over 30,000 students enrolled in one or more courses in those subject areas alone. So that's a lot of kids will see these materials. So thanks to all of you for your time.
Okay. Thank you. So if you need to sneak out, go quietly.
Or the rain.
Safe travels.
We'll wait about 30 seconds, I think. Thanks. What'd you do to your arm there?
It's a ladder, a roof, and a stone patio.
Oh.
Heard that story frequently. Yeah, yeah.
Husbands are
yes, 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 yes.
Be
yes.
Careful. The most outstanding Latin teacher I have in Northside. Ouch. Okay. The next order of business is from the Business and Finance Department. It's an order canceling some parts of the single member district election. Mr. Rastellini.
Thank you, Ms. Reed. Last month, we asked the board to consider calling an election for Board of Trustees, single member district 5, 6, and 7, and we did with an order that was passed by resolution from the board. Under certain circumstances, those elections can be canceled subsequent to meeting certain dates and requirements. Outlined in your agenda item this evening are the three criteria that must be met before the district can cancel election. For each candidate that is running must be unopposed for that particular district. The ballot or the election must be one where the write-in candidacy is required as from a declaration, and that is the case with our elections. And finally, no other proposition is lit ballot. You will see in the attachment my certification as the elections officer of the district that for single member district 5 and 7, those criteria have been met. And along with that, the order attached is to cancel those two elections with single member district 6 election continuing as scheduled on May 6th.
Okay. So can we do them together?
Yes, the order of cancellation is in one order.
Okay. Do I hear a motion? Oh. Somebody?
Yeah, I'll move for cancellation for single member districts 5 and 7 as presented.
Second. If there are no other comments. It has been moved that we approve the order canceling the elections in districts 5 and 7. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried. Thank you.
Thank you.
That saves us how much money? A bit. A bit.
Each election is probably about $80,000.
So okay. And in case you do not know, which districts are 5 and 7? That would be Ms. Freeman and myself, so just for your knowledge. Okay. The next item is,
Administration.
First reading and adoption of legal practices. Mr. Galindo.
Mrs. Reed, Dr. Woods, members of the board, on or in your agenda, you have two attachments. One's a summary of the legal policies from update 107. The other one is the actual 23, I believe, legal policies. And they range in everything from credentials and records for IAs to some student accounting issues and even wellness and health review that we'll need to do with one of our policies. But I'll happy to report that our practices and policies are in line with the legal that were submitted with this update. So all that said, because these are legal policies, we ask for your approval and adoption and go into the local policies in more in-depth discussion.
So we're looking at the first reading on both of these?
Yes, ma'am.
Adoption of the legal ones. I was trying to get back to the right screen
on my computer, and I missed some of what you said.
The summary has about a half dozen of legals that I think are of interest to you, and the rest of the 23 are there as well.
And the policy committee has already looked at these. Is that correct? Who's in charge of policy?
That's right. Ms. Reed, if you don't mind, we did meet several occasions, and we reviewed legal policies, and at this time, we'll move in motion approval.
It's been moved and seconded that we approve the adoption of legal policies as presented. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed, no. Motion carried. And then the local policies, this is first reading, and they will come back next month, right?
Correct. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So also attached are the actual policies along with a summary, and I'd ask that you follow with the actual policies, and I'll kind of walk through those. There were nine, unlike other updates, which can be very lengthy. This one was pretty minor, and the changes to our policies were minimal. Half of these policies were in HR, and you'll see a pattern in that the change was the same. It just affected a couple of different policies, and so we can begin with CDC local that deals with gifts and solicitations. This is a new policy and deals exactly with that, unsolicited gifts and solicitations. There's language there you'll see at the very beginning of the policy that authorizes the superintendent to accept unsolicited gifts if it meets the criteria acceptance, and they have an itemized list there for you of nine different things ranging from the item having to have and be consistent with the district's educational philosophy to, if you scroll down to number nine, not having any negative effects on the physical structure or the building if it's something that's related to one of the facilities. On page 2 of 2 of this policy, you'll see language there that addresses any internet or web-based type of solicitations, including crowdfunding. And currently, thanks to the finance group, we actually are already ahead of the game here, and we have an admin reg that addresses this. Including the fact that it has a form that it requires principal or supervisor approval before anything is solicited via the internet. And so those are the three majors. You'll also see, if you're scrolling along in red, some additional changes made by the finance folks that we added along with the TASB policy. And so that's the summary of CDC local.
Okay. So we will look forward to those coming back next month.
Right.
And if you have any questions about them, please contact Mr.
Got just a few more.
You have a few more.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll love you one.
Okay.
I'll be brief.
I'm just trying to move.
The next two policies come as a result of every student's SSA. The language in these policies prohibit employment assistance to any individual that is believed to have engaged in sexual misconduct with any minor or student or any student. So as district employees, if we know of or have any even probable cause that someone engaged in this type of behavior, in no way can we assist these individuals in getting a job. And so I said this affects two policies. The first one, CJ, which deals with contracted services. The follow-up to this, which deals with employees, is DC, And so again, same language for both policies that basically have the same effect, which is in no way can any of these individuals, even with probable cause, be assisted in trying to find a new job.
Okay.
The next three, literally, it is one word that is changed, and both, or I should say all three of these policies deal with contracts. One is probationary contracts, one is term contracts, and one is a continuing contract. And so for all of these individuals, the word or is changed to and in the first line of every one of these policies to clarify that. And basically to state that suspension with pay is the same as administrative leave, meaning that anyone on these contracts, if they're on admin leave, are on admin leave with pay. So again, very short policies with the one word change. The next one is FEA. This one deals with attendance. And the recommended changes for this one come as a result of the Texas Student Data System. Policy now explains that students who are homeschooled are exempt from compulsory attendance, as you would imagine, but also addresses that the district will accept, what the district will accept as adequate documentation of homeschooling when a student withdraws from us. So something that, again, we have already asking and have a form that we use to request that there is that assurance from a parent that these children are being educated with some sort of curriculum and not just being withdrawn. And if they don't provide us with something, we actually can pursue legal action. The last two policies, Mrs. Reed, deal with fundraising and in terms of students and also parent organizations. So FJ deals with student fundraising specifically. Major revision to this one, as you'll see, and the name itself was changed to student fundraising from gifts and solicitations. The new language here now details that fundraising plans, approval of activities, reporting of fundraising all need to be addressed via admin regs, and then everything else moves to GE, which is the last policy to summarize. So the remaining language in what you see in FJ basically states that students should participate in approved activities that, one, benefit the district, two, relate to the district's educational mission, three, that fundraising doesn't occur during class time, and then four, that fundraising involves that involves the sale of food and beverage that can be consumed during the day must comply with the federal competitive food standards, which, again, all happy to report that we've been doing in practice for quite some time. And then finally, GE Local deals with parent organizations and their fundraising. And the changes to this policy focus on activities, again, basically boosters and PTAs. And the revisions clarify that when these groups fundraise or solicit donations, the activities must, one, be consistent with the district's philosophy, once again, follow board policy, as well as admin regs, and then be in accordance, if it's secondary, with UIL and any other governing type of association if they're involved. And then finally, very important, that these organizations, again, although they're parent and boosters, that they notify their principal or the administrator before engaging in that fundraising or soliciting type of activity or donation. So that is a quick summary, Mrs. Reed, of the update 107 policies. If you're scrolling along, there is one more that is included, which is not part of update 107, but comes from HR. It's a very minor change, and I'm scrolling to it myself. On page 7 of 9 has a one-word change that needed to be done so that we are in line with our practice. And that last one is DEC. Again, that was not part of the update 107.
Okay.
And this is first reading, so of course, if there's any questions or concerns, be glad to answer your questions before next month.
Okay. Or if you have a question right now, you can ask it also. So.
Correct.
Yeah.
I just want to say, I know we're going to review it. Thanks for the, I like the way it's organized now. It's
Thank
been
you.
Built up over time to have the highlights. Then you sort of know what to look for. Then the annotation, the red, blue, et cetera, helps out. So you know, thanks for making it easier for us to take a look.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate that.
Okay. Okay. Nothing else. We will review it again next month.
Correct. Thank you, Mrs. Reed.
Sorry for me skipping ahead.
That's
too much.
Okay.
Okay, Superintendent, future agenda items.
Yes, ma'am. Several items in your blue folder at your place. One, of course, is the list of future agenda items. You'll see at the April called meeting, we did add the discussion of naming for Grossenbacher Elementary on the April called meeting. So you'll note that we will have a couple of other items in addition to the normal budget work session items for you on that evening. So there's your next meeting and future agenda items. Just to walk through what else is in here, you've also got a list of area soccer playoffs. We've got four teams left in the playoffs that will be playing this Friday, so you've got that listing. And then a number of invitations to upcoming events. Next week, we've got the auditorium naming ceremony at John Marshall High School.
Not this week.
Sorry.
That's Thursday.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Ms. McGee would not let me not go, so I will definitely be there. Not a problem.
Next week.
Sorry, next. Now I'm on to next week. On the 4th, the 25th anniversary of Stinson Middle School, you've got an invitation in there for the annual Northside Retiree Luncheon in the middle of this month. On that same day, the 25th anniversary of Business Careers High School Partner of the Year Awards. The one thing I would note on Partner of the Year is we have moved that to the sports gym. So those of us who are kind of programmed to go to Paul Taylor, note change of location for that.
Is there enough room on the floor there for all the exhibits and right. the art? Because it's a little smaller floor space, isn't it?
I think the answer's plenty.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah, I think so. I think they've determined that we're going to be able to spread out a little more. So.
Oh, upstairs, yeah. Okay.
And then you've got Celebrity Reader, during Week of the Young Child, and then Science and Technology Night at Boone. You've also got TASB SLI booklet attached as well, and I think Ms. McGee had that in last week's Friday letter. A number of upcoming items.
Patricia Mosquito. Okay. Anything else?
That's it, Ms. Reed.
Okay. So, that having been said, I think that takes us to the closed meeting. The Board of Trustees on March 28th, 2017, beginning at 8:05, will convene in a closed meeting in accordance with Texas Government Code Sections 551.074. Discussion will take place on items A through H on the agenda. All those cannot stay, we're glad that you were here and hope that you felt we did a good job, and we'll look forward to seeing you around Northside again. Thank you. Thanks for being here. Okay. The Board of Trustees on March 28th, beginning at 8:47 p.m., will convene an open meeting. Action will take place on the following items, A through E, omitting item F, and item G. Do I hear a motion?
Madam Chair, I move that we approve the administrative appointments A through E plus G as discussed in executive session.
Okay. Thank you. Any other discussion on that? If not, it's been moved and seconded that we approve A through E plus G. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, no. Motion carries. Thank you. And the board is now ending our meeting at 8:48. 8:48, pardon me. 8:48.